No, not again. You haven't had that before. Take it down.
I had a green one today after lunch.
Meditol? Are you sure?
Meditol, I don't know, but green, I know. First time I had green. See, now I've had red, blue, yellow.
Who gave it to you?
My grandma, of course.
Miss Higgins?
Yeah, the old one. How old do you suppose she is, anyway? One thing I do know. Everything's been shoved into me since I came to this hospital.
Excuse me. Everything!
All right, Doctor. Thank you. Liz.
What's the trouble?
Mr. Toller's medication is the trouble.
Well, this is what you asked for. Meditol?
But there's nothing in the orders that says he's supposed to have it twice a day.
No. No, he's not.
Well, according to Mr. Toller, he had it at noon.
Noon? Meditol?
It's Miss Higgins again.
There was a change in the medication. But I didn't tell her Meditol. There's an order here from Dr. Stanley for a half a grain of ptolamine.
Well, whatever it was, he got Meditol. And this isn't the first time Miss Higgins has gotten mixed up on things lately. Frankly, Liz, being responsible for myself is enough. I don't want to have to worry about Higgy's duties.
Of course not.
And I'm really not the only nurse on the floor that thinks that way.
All right, I'll talk to her about it again. In the meantime, hold up on his medication. I'll speak to Dr. Stanley about it when he comes in. I'll take that.
Look, Liz, I don't want to put old Higgy on the carpet, but...
Don't apologize. You're fully justified. Has Higgy left yet?
I just relieved her. She should be out in a minute.
Get on with the other people, then. Miss Higgins. Miss Higgins.
Yes, Mrs. Sutton.
Could I speak to you a moment, please? Do you remember earlier today that I gave you a change in Mr. Toller's medication?
Yes.
But you've given him Meditol.
Yes.
I told you ptolamine.
No. You said Meditol.
Miss Higgins, I have it noted here. I repeated it on the phone to Dr. Stanley, and then I repeated it to you.
And I, Mrs. Thorpe, repeated it to you. Meditol.
Ptolamine, Miss Higgins. Look, Higgy, this isn't the first time, you know, that it's been this sort of mix-up with you.
I don't appreciate the inference that I am guilty, and that you and everybody else couldn't be.
Look, Higgy, I don't want to start an argument here with you.
What am I supposed to say? Thank you?
A patient has been incorrectly medicated.
I am a well-trained nurse, Mrs. Thorpe, and I know more about patient care than all your girls can ever hope to know.
Just a moment. Miss Higgins.
You take your little pigeons and keep them out of their dreams of labor unions and their fight for better lounges and longer vacations and more money and put them on their toes as nurses the way I was trained to be a nurse, and maybe you won't have mistakes on your floor.
Higgy, please.
Meditol, Mrs. Thorpe, Meditol.
This portion of The Nurses is presented by Anacin, the headache remedy with a special combination of ingredients to relieve pain, fight depression, calm jittery nerves. Anacin.
Your temperature's up. You have a fever, headache, that ache all over feeling of a cold. Don't settle for any aspirin. Take Anacin. Tablet for tablet, Anacin brings better relief from cold's miseries. That is, longer lasting relief than any leading aspirin. Minutes after taking Anacin, fever goes down, headache pain's gone, grippy body aches fade. Relief lasts longer. You see, Anacin is like a doctor's prescription. That is, a combination of ingredients. The ingredient most recommended by doctors for cold's miseries, plus an extra ingredient missing from leading aspirins, still missing with buffering, combined in Anacin. Anacin relieves headache pain fast, reduces fever fast, relieves body aches fast. So remember, next time you have a cold, don't settle for any aspirin. Take Anacin. Tablet for tablet, Anacin brings better relief. That is, longer lasting relief than any leading aspirin.
Beginning to think this thing lights up at the Savoy Plaza Hotel.
Is there anything wrong, Miss Ivers?
No. I should have had one of those tranquilizers in my blood an hour ago. Look, I'm trying to get well, not raise my blood pressure.
Of course, Mr. Pryor.
Where's Miss Higgins?
Higgy? Miss Higgins? Miss Higgins is probably tied up in one of the other rooms.
And I'd still be calm and collected if I could be running my business instead of having had this stroke or whatever you call the thing, having to retire to a wheelchair for the rest of my days worrying about Miss Higgins and a half grain of Thanamil.
I understand, Mr. Pryor. I'll get Miss Higgins right away.
Yes, Mr. Pryor. Your light was on?
Pryor is due for medication, Miss Higgins. Would you take care of it, please?
I can handle it, Miss Lucas, thank you.
Animal half grain.
She could have been busy. Sometimes that boy can get you awfully mixed up.
Oh, you students. First you complain about her and then you defend her.
Well, we are understaffed.
From the looks of her eyes, I'd say Miss Higgins had been asleep. That wouldn't be the first time. Oh, take care of that, will you, please? Higgy, could we have lunch together today? Miss Higgins, could we have lunch together today?
I hope my old age won't find me limping through these corridors.
Can you hear me, Verna?
Sure, why? I said I could hear you.
Just testing.
I didn't mean to cause trouble. Well, it's the end of a long day, and I'm just as tired of lying here as you are of running around these hallways.
And what makes you think I'm tired, Mr. Pryor?
Oh, there's no reason why you shouldn't be. Heaven knows, before I left my business, my old pins weren't doing the job they used to either. Now, wait, I didn't mean to hurt you.
May I speak to you for a moment?
I'm tired, Mrs. Saw. I'm going home. It's been a long day.
You were tired when it started. That's what I came to say.
Well, what started?
The day. You got here at 8 and you were tired before 9. You were tired by 9 yesterday and the day before. And last week and last month.
I'm a nurse. Are you trying to make me a patient?
No.
Then what is this little meeting here? Don't I do my job? Attend to my patients, look after their safety and health, perform the mission of the nurse in the treating of disease the way I was trained to treat it for the past 47 years?
You know, there was a time when every doctor who had a real problem with a patient
always screamed for you. Because you were the best nurse on the floor. And probably in the whole hospital. But not anymore. I didn't come here to hurt you, Hickey.
Oh? Then you've bungled your job.
Please listen. Don't run away.
I don't want to talk.
You're not the same woman you were 47 years ago, Hickey.
Who the devil is?
No one is.
Then what is this about? Is it because I didn't get to Mr. Pryor at the crack of the whip? Or is it about the other day with the medicine?
A mistake I did not make. But even if I had made it, aren't we entitled to mistake? You make mistakes? Of course.
We're human machines, aren't we?
But only human machines. Some of us tend to expect so much of ourselves. It isn't humanly possible. I have respect for your kind of dedication, Hickey, but...
Thank you. Do I get a gold watch?
I'm not handing out watches. I'm simply trying to explain that one isn't as efficient at the age of 65
as... 66.
As one is at 30 or 40 or 50.
I'm a responsible nurse.
No, you are not a responsible nurse. Not when you have trouble keeping your hand steady when you administer a hypodermic. Not when the nurses can't read the notes on your charts.
Good night.
Look, there are other jobs available. Easier jobs. Nursing homes, private homes, positions with less responsibility.
This is what I was trained for, this. This hospital is all I know. It's all I've ever known. Don't you dare try to take it away from me.
Like that. You tell me there's no place for me here anymore. Just like that.
It isn't that you're a sick woman, Miss Higgins. Even your physical indicates that you've a good many years left. They can be good years, valuable years. You've got a good mind.
And what would you suggest I do with all these years? Take all the money I've earned as a nurse plus my miserable little savings and scramble off and have myself a holiday? Thank you very much.
There are things to talk about, to make sense of. Don't make tigers of us.
Higgy, Miss Robert is right. You must consider your future. Please let us help you.
You know something? Until recently, I never thought about time, how old I was. I knew how many patients I had, how many minims in a milliliter, how many grains in a gram. And now there's nothing left to count but time. Clocks. They're really ugly, aren't they?
Higgy. Oops, sorry, Higgy.
Higgy, I just wanted to...
47 years. Just like that. Couldn't you have just shot me?
Don't lie awake again tonight. Take Sleepies. The next thing you know, it's morning. Sleep safely with Sleepies, effective as phenobarbital, yet no drug hangover, no drug habit. When your wake center is active, you can't sleep. Medically proved Sleepies turns off the wake center, brings on the start of sleep. You close your eyes, next thing you know, it's morning. Sleepies, used as directed, effective as phenobarbital, yet so safe. No drug hangover, no drug habit.
Good morning, Miss Higgins.
Morning, Higgy.
Last day for Hickey.
Yes, she's counting the hours now.
What must it feel like after so long?
It needn't be doomsday.
I've often thought about growing old. Not worth the energy to think about it, though, is it?
It's well worth the energy. Not enough people do think of it. Come here. You've seen them around. Your case in point, Mr. Robertson. There's no reason for him to be ill. He has no reason to die. But he will, and sooner than he should. Because he has no reason to live anymore. He has no hope in him.
So pitiful.
Don't pity them. Help them.
I do my best.
Oh, I don't mean with drugs and sick room supplies and bed trays. Something much more important than that is to make them feel worthwhile. They're old people, but they're still part of society. That's the most painful disease you'll ever look upon, Miss Lucas. Uselessness. Both inside a hospital and out.
What do you think about Miss Higgins?
I don't know. Sometimes it sneaks up very quickly. And when people start counting the hours, I don't know.
Why are you angry?
I am, aren't I? I guess it's because I've seen so many people suffer when they didn't have to if they'd been ready. But twilight could be lovely for so many people. Don't hesitate to dream of a happy ending. It's well worth the energy.
African safari. Ever see Africa, Higgins?
No.
Ever see anything that didn't have white walls, medicine smells? I bet you've never even been to the beach.
Hospitals are a full-time job, Mr. Pryor.
No such thing as full-time job. Would you fetch me my wheelchair? I want to practice my driving. You know, I'm going to be leaving here one of these days, and I want to get used to that frontless rumble seat. Yeah. You take this going away gift. You like it. Give you a new point of view.
I don't read much. But thank you anyway. I'll take the thought. Now, legs around.
What do you do? Hmm? What are you going to do when you leave here at 4:30 tonight, huh?
Don't worry about me. Here we go.
You know, you're not going to take me by yourself, huh?
I can handle you. Rest on my shoulders.
Now, don't be so hard-headed, huh? Nurse!
I can do it myself. Now, come quickly. Pull up.
Now, don't be stubborn. You can't brace me.
May I help?
Yes, would you please give us old guys a hand, huh?
I can do it myself, Miss Lucas. I'm quite able to.
It's all right, Hickey. I'll help you.
Please, Miss Lucas. It's simpler if I do it myself.
Yeah. Here we go. Here we go. Into the rumble seat.
Miss Higgins, be careful. Have a nice ride.
I'm not a lightweight.
You can handle it from here. I have some things to see about.
Miss Higgins, you're not as old as your legs. I know younger people who can't even walk. They make livings, have families, get along very nicely.
Please, Mr. Pryor. I don't require any sophomoric, sympathetic lectures.
She's up till 4:30.
Right down to the wire, isn't she?
Mm-hmm. Well, I guess I'll relieve her. Trade places? Miss Higgins. Higgy! Higgy, it's 4:30. Shall I take him for you? Higgy, much, but we wanted to remember you and thought you might like something to remember Alden by. And good luck. Miss Higgins, it's for you.
Music upstairs again. You want me to tell him to stop? Huh? She looks gray this evening. A gray old lady this evening.
Tomorrow.
best things in life are free. Family fun, friendly games, and the wonderful free gifts you can get by smoking Raleigh cigarettes and saving Raleigh coupons. Gifts for the whole family, like this dartboard set, this cooler, and this corn popper. All free for Raleigh coupons. This couple lives a good life, and they enjoy those Raleigh gifts.
Most of all, we enjoy that wonderful Raleigh taste. That's why we smoke them. But we do like to get those Raleigh coupons.
We sure do. And they're so quick and easy to save.
Raleigh coupons, good for free gifts.
And now, for the first time, you can get famous Raleigh coupons with a light menthol cigarette. Yes, Bel Air, filter tip Bel Air, now has Raleigh coupons. And Bel Air is so refreshing.
There's a light touch of menthol in a Bel Air cigarette. Just the right touch of menthol in a Bel Air cigarette. So look for the pack with the coupon on the back. Smoke Bel Air, new Bel Air.
Buy Bel Air and Raleigh by the carton and get four extra coupons. Raleigh coupons on Raleigh filter tip or plain end. And now on Bel Air light menthol cigarettes. This portion of The Nurses has been presented by the packs with a famous Raleigh coupon on the backs, Raleigh, filter tip or plain end, and Bel Air light menthol cigarettes.
Youngsters like Leslie Susan have a better chance for fewer cavities. That's because a while back, Don Morrow took part in a toothpaste test. Don, what were the results?
After 2 years, my group had 34% fewer cavities with Crest.
You know what the other group used?
It was the Crest formula, but without Fluoristan.
Tests like Don's make Crest the only toothpaste recognized effective by the American Dental Association. Here's the statement of their therapeutics council. Crest has been shown to be an effective, decay-preventive dentifrice that can be of significant value when used in a conscientiously applied program of oral hygiene and regular professional care. Do as the Morrows do. In your dental program, have regular checkups. Watch between meal treats. Brush often. With Crest. Remember.
My group had 34% fewer cavities with Crest.
All right, I'll go along.
Oh, I don't think he knows what he wants.
Just find out. Perhaps his thought can help you this. Someone about Marcella, I guess.
This is Mrs. Thorpe. Yes?
Well, I mean, things making a change for the different. I didn't want to take a chance on trouble, you know? Oh. Yeah? Oh, I didn't know that. Well, she's not a big talker, but you think at least she'd tell somebody if she's not a nurse anymore.
Oh, but she is a nurse. She just isn't working here at the hospital any longer.
Oh, retired, huh? Oh, no, no, I just wanted to let you know.
Thank you for being interested, Mrs. Mesro. Goodbye. Hickey's landlady. Trouble. She seems to be the kind to look for it. Hope she doesn't find it.
Not her. It's the chickie.
Oh, boy. 3 days in that room. I think I ought to call that nurse again.
Maybe she hasn't got anything to do outside her room.
A city like this, nothing to do.
Like what?
Like what? Like live a life. I mean, you walk around. You talk to this one, you talk to that one, you see what's happening. I mean, like yourself. You come down here, you talk to me. You call that nothing to do?
Higgy, Higgy, please open the door. Do you have a pass key?
Well, yeah, here. But you better be careful. You know, she might be dangerous.
Oh. Higgy, I have a key. I'm coming in just to talk to you. Marcella? Marcella!
You go away.
Come inside, Marcella.
I'm all right. Go away.
Come on in and we can talk.
I'm not going to jump.
I didn't think you were.
As much as you'd like me to, I'm not going to jump.
Now, that kind of talk isn't going to solve anything, is it?
Everybody keeps asking how you are and what you're doing. Mr. Pryor asks for you. He keeps hoping you'll come back to see him. I couldn't even help the old man to a wheelchair. Well, you could now. He can help himself a little bit better now. It would be easier for both of you. Isn't there somebody I can call? A friend? I know you have no family. I just want to be let alone. I don't want anybody feeling sorry for me. I just came by to see if you're all right. As for feeling sorry, you're doing a very good job of that yourself, Marcella. Do you have any food here? Will you go back inside if I leave?
And then when I walked into that room, it was like a cell, drab and colorless. David, there weren't even any pictures. Just stark, blank walls.
I have too many blank walls in this city.
But it's so self-destructive. I mean, devoting her life to her work this way. It's as if she martyred herself. She has no life at all, and no inner resources. And yet there are things that she could do, but she simply won't listen to reason.
First of all, we know she's obstinate. The important thing to realize is she's had quite a shock. Some people just aren't ready. They aren't able to adapt.
Well, what are we going to do? Someone has to help her.
I think for a while, we both have to be psychiatrists. Keep an eye on her. Use our wisdom. Have compassion.
But don't push.
Not too much. Old as a person is, they still have to help themselves. That first step, just like a baby's first step, has to be theirs.
I mean, no matter what you say, she'll just say hello.
Thank you, Mrs. Mesra. I'm sure we can have it from here on in.
The door's open, you know. She don't keep it locked anymore. You should see it in there.
Miss Higgins? Miss Higgins, it's Mrs. Thorpe. Dr. Sanger is with me. Could we talk to you for a moment?
We were in the neighborhood, Higgy. We thought we'd stop by and see how you are.
How are you, Higgy?
What have you been doing with yourself?
I walk a lot.
Good. We should all do more of that. What's the laugh for? Have you been looking for work? I wish you'd talk to me. We're old friends, you know. Any new friends? Who?
Down the hall. They'll play the music again tonight. They do most every night. I like that.
Good.
Sometimes I dance to it.
Iggy, when you visit your friends at the hospital, would you come in and see me? You know me well enough to talk to me. Tell me how you feel. After all, you can't stay shut up in this room for the rest of your life, can you?
Rest of my life is over.
It needn't be.
Sometimes the music is so fast, I trip. I dance and trip. And I sat down on my knees, and the music wouldn't stop. And I thought...
About what?
About when I was a child, and I would get to my knees and pray. And I knew that outside, everything kept going. Like the music. Clocks and stores and trolley cars. It used to frighten me. To think that everybody didn't go to bed at the same time. So I pray for my sister and my brother and my mother and my father. I pray they would be all right. I always worried about them. They're all dead now. They had good lives. I think about them sometimes. I miss them sometimes. The music was so fast, I tripped and fell to my knees.
Remember, you come in and see me. I mean it, Higgy.
No. I don't want to come see you.
Goodbye, Higgy. Just for now. Please call us if you want anything.
Bye.
Have a TV? You like to talk? It's good to talk sometimes. I like to talk. I got a son in Newark and a daughter. They come to dinner sometimes on Sunday when my husband was alive. And they would talk, all of them. And I would do for them. I was going to live with them, but then we decided no. I like a good game of gin rummy. What are you sewing?
The buttons came off one night.
Oh, did you give Mr. Robertson's report to Dr. Phillips?
That I did.
Good. Look, when you're free, would you sit with Mrs. Shane for a while? I think she needs some company.
That I will.
Thanks.
Liz. Good morning.
Good morning, Miss Higgins.
Why, Mr. Robertson. How have you been?
Higgy.
They left you here all alone?
Higgy, what are you doing?
I'm on duty.
Call
well, Dr. Sanger. I'll take you out for a little ride in the sun porch.
Higgy, why don't you help me here at the desk?
Hmm? No, I'm taking care of a patient.
Higgy? Higgy? Higgy?
Please.
No! No, all right, dear. No, no, I belong here.
You're going to be just fine. No.
Higgy? You're taking my patient away! You're taking my patient away!
Hi. I just thought I'd tell you again, you're going to be just fine. Do you remember coming here, Higgy?
I remember.
You gave us quite a...
I said I remember.
Is there something you'd like before Dr. Sanger gets here?
It'd be my clothes. I want to go home.
You are home, Higgy. Please stay with us. Let us help you.
I don't need help.
Let's let Dr. Sanger be the judge of that, hmm?
Leave me alone.
Anything to report before I brave the lion's den?
I'll say.
Any change in her attitude?
None whatsoever. She still wants to go home.
Well, she can't.
What's the prognosis?
Once I begin cutting through the wall of antagonism, I'll be able to answer your question. I'll be able to answer a few of my own.
You're looking much better today, Miss Higgins. Is there anything you'd like?
No.
Mr. Pryor said to say hello. You know, he still reads everything he can get his hands on. He's a very wonderful man, isn't he?
Is he?
Mr. Pryor's very fond of you. The library card's still on the floor. If you'd like me to get you something, I...
I said I didn't want anything. I don't want a book. I don't want Mr. Pryor, and I don't want any more of your adolescent chit-chat.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to upset you. If you change your mind, buzz me.
Lucas make you angry?
A little innuendos.
Innuendos?
Mr. Pryor says hello, she says. She knows what Mr. Pryor means to me, how she treated me that day with the wheelchair. And she walks out and says, push the buzzer if you need me. That's how it all started with the buzzer. She knows that. She marches in and shoots little dots.
You feel that you've been treated disrespectfully all your years here at Alden?
Would I be in this bed if I weren't? They must have great jokes about me sitting around the lunch table together, talking about old Higgy.
They talk about you a lot, do they?
Of course they do, especially the young ones.
Why the young ones especially?
Why? Because they're so young. That's all they can do is talk. You heard her, what she said to me.
Well, actually, I came in just at the end. What did she say?
She wants me to read books. She knows I have no time for books. While I'm lying here reading, who'll look after my patients?
You have a lot of patients to look after?
Of course I do. The hospital is understaffed. All of us have more patients than we can look after.
And perhaps you need some help with all those patients of yours. That's what these youngsters are here for. Let you get some rest.
I can't take a rest, you know that. Dr. Howland Smith always wants me to look after his cases.
Dr. Howland Smith?
You know him. He'll come in a moment and shout at me, Higgy, keep an eye on that one for me. You're the only nurse I can trust not to call me at 4 o'clock in the morning in a panic because one of my patients sneezed.
Dr. Howland Smith must be very old man by now.
He said I was the best nurse he'd ever met.
When was this, Higgy?
Best nurse he'd ever met. That's why he left me all his books and his will.
What did you do with them?
All those books. I sold most of them. Didn't have anywhere to put them.
That was many years ago.
I was 25 years old.
Iggy, I suggest you stay right where you are. Let these nurses wait on you for a change. You've earned it. I'll stop by every day and we'll talk. Talk about anything you feel like talking about. Okay? I'll have to put on a few pounds.
You could visit your tailor. That way it won't look as if we haven't fed you.
About the food, I won't boast. But the service?
You know, every now and then a nurse gets selfish and has to tell a patient how sorry she'll be that he's leaving. I think I'll miss hearing about all your plans.
And my book reports. Mm. You know, I have to thank you. Opened up a whole new world for me, poetry. Goodbye.
Bye, Mr. Pryor.
Bye.
Your nephew is waiting for you downstairs. I already sent your bag down.
Thank you. Just a moment, please. I wonder if I could visit my old friend.
Miss Higgins. Uh-huh. I don't see any reason why not.
Well, I'll take you. She's right around the corner at 814.
No. I'll do my own navigating. You know, I'm thinking of joining one of those wheelchair basketball teams.
I don't doubt that for a moment.
Come in.
Passed my driving test. I'm going home.
I'm glad you're well.
Well, I had good care, starting with you. You seem to be recovering nicely.
So everyone in the hospital's talking about me?
Did I say everybody in the hospital's talking about you? No, what I meant was that I'm happy to see you feeling better.
Thank you.
Gruff. You are gruff. But then I'm not exactly Mr. Gentle, am I? But we did seem to get along pretty well together in our own way, didn't we? Oh, by the way, when you do leave here, I'll be needing somebody to stay with me at my home. I'm offering you the position. I'm not a poor man. I have other help. You won't have to cook or clean.
What you're saying is that you are offering to help me.
Is that what I was saying? No, old Higgins. What I meant was, I need a nurse. I thought you might like the job. But come to think of it, I believe I can help you, too. Oh, yes, I brought a book. Something in it hit me. I thought you might like to share it with me. Robert Browning. Ever read poetry, Higgins?
No.
Well, neither did I. The little girl thought that I should. I think you should, too. Well, here it is. I've got it marked. Yeah. Grow old along with me. The best is yet to be. The last of life. For which the first was made. Here. Read it. You might learn something. Don't steal it. It's a library book. Goodbye.
I'm not a thief, Mr. Pryor.
Aren't you? You've stolen the joy out of my visit to you. Why? Did I do something to you? I like you. I even need you. And yet you stole the joy. You think I hated a lot of people when I found out I couldn't go back to work? To a business I built up with my own hands? Yes, I was angry. All right, so there's anger in the air. Be angry if that's what you want. But why be angry with me if you're not competent to go on working in these hallways? Is it my fault? I'm not competent to continue in my business, but it's nobody's fault. Those are the facts. What's so terrible about it? At least I'm offering you a place to go. Me, I have to sit in my rumble seat for the rest of my life.
I don't want charity.
I'm not offering you anything free. You'll have to work for what I give you. Don't you see I'm asking you to come and help me because you're a good nurse and because I like you? I don't know why I like you. I mean, I could have a sister-in-law or Cousin Lena if I wanted, but I don't want Cousin Lena, if you knew Cousin Lena.
I can't lift you out of that chair.
Yes, you can.
No, I tried. I can't.
Come on. Try again. You'll see. You can do it.
Look, I can help you now. I'm not such a dead weight anymore. There's life in this old man yet, but not enough that I don't need help. Don't you understand? You can help me, and maybe I can help you, too. Come on, try. You can lift me. Help me, you hear? Come on, now. You help me. You see, I need you. When you need me, let me know. I'm in the telephone book. The business is in the yellow pages. Me, I'm retired. I'm in the white pages. Bye.
Goodbye, Mr. Pryor. We'll miss you.
The pleasure has been all mine. This isn't exactly a resort, but... You, Mouse? Grow up nice. You hear me? Home, James?
This is Cheryl Conway. We'd like to show you some scenes from the next episode of The Nurses.
Would you tell me how I can certify his death? How we can avoid calling in the medical examiner?
Give it to me, I'll sign it.
It could never be casual with me.
You don't have to apologize to me.
I'm not. I'm trying to tell you that I love you very, very much. And I want you very, very much.
The fact remains, she is a nurse.
Sure. If she did, it was all wrong. But if you or Dr. McAllister had gone in that room and pulled out that needle, that would have been all right. Because you're qualified medically, it's all right morally and ethically. And certainly legally, because you could have signed the death certificate and that would have been that. That's the way it is done, isn't it?
Please watch our next show, A Question of Mercy, starring Cheryl Conway, Madeline Rue, William Shatner, Edward Binns, and me, Zena Bethune. Mm-hmm.